As you can see right here, we have NASDAQ on our 4-hour time frame. If you look at our price at our 12.024, run about the section, a bit higher than that, obviously. So the market drop and never picked up ever since then. Initially, it's because America's back in lockdown. And of course, obviously, because of the elections. Most of the countries around the world also are back in lockdown, including Apple, didn't actually launch successfully. So that obviously forced our downfall. In our down movement, technical to the downside. At this current time, what I do actually realize with our technical movements that the market always moves technically, obviously, as we know. Even our down movement were definitely profitable as we move down. Try to make sure that we eat as much as we can off the sells and just sneak up on the buys whenever we could. Right now, I would say we're sitting on a sell resistance. Should the market break to the upside, giving us an up movement that obviously would allow us to actually now start being more confident with our buys. We're currently moving at around 11.172, somewhere around there. Quite still confident about our downside movement. The market did give us, let me just change time frame. The market did obviously give us 2-hour time frame trading view, allows me to obviously see better. The market here at this section, you can see that it actually did give us a double bottom and around our low section. You can see that I've actually highlighted there. This zone right here at the bottom at around 1099 right here. So still confident. I see the market is pushing back up. It's pushing up back up to this section here. We have to wait and see if the market is definitely going to resist there or actually break that phase of the market. Should we break it, we're definitely waiting for our buyers to push to the upside. Seeing a resistance there will definitely give us a downside push. When I see nice sellers coming out again, and then we drop it quite confidently. Currently watching the elections, we see that Trump might be looking for a win. Might be actually be giving a win. I'm not much of a fundamental trader, so I wouldn't put all my money on that. But I'll tell you that if he does win, we're going to have a push, a comfortable push, fundamental push to the upside, seeing us obviously with the market will definitely start gaining its momentum. And then obviously a bit of an update of the pandemic will definitely can tell that the corona virus is kind of weighing a bit off on the market. So should other states or in other countries start jumping out of lockdown, we're gonna see our NASDAQ definitely move how we actually are used to it. Looking at the history, you can tell that this is the NASDAQ that we want to see move, the upside pushing. We're not too happy with how NASDAQ has moved this whole year, but however, we can sneak on and eat a bit of what we can. My signals are definitely gonna help you understand the market a bit better. With this video, I want to make you understand that we are not in the best forms of NASDAQ movement. However, we have to keep eating the little pips that we actually do get from this graph. Looking at this, like I did say, just change time frame so I can show you guys. I don't go to a smaller time frame so I can show you exactly what I'm talking about when I say that. Let's do 30 minutes. At this point, you can see we definitely took a buy at this at our low. At this low section where 1099.3 took a buy at this 1099.3, took another buy right here at 11.069. The market definitely just pushed up now, passing our small high that I've actually highlighted with this line here. I don't know if you can see it as I move it past our high. I see the market coming back to come around that zone there and giving us our little, obviously our short buy again to push the upside. It's currently definitely still sitting on, it's approaching the high that we actually want, which is currently at, let's do this just like that. So it's approaching that high at 11.214. Getting to that high, I want to see the market breaking that high if we want our buys positively. When the market refuses to break that high, we're definitely giving us another drop, and we'll definitely come back down and give us a triple bottom, as we already have obviously our one bottom here, second one section there, as you can see. Should the market drop, we'll give us our third low, then we'll buy again. But if it refuses to break around our 11.214, we're definitely dropping. If it does break, we'll come back and sit on around our 11.214. And then push up to the upside. Going a bit lower to smaller time frames. Let me show you guys this. There we go. Show you guys that? Let's move it a bit to a different time frame. Let's see what 15 minutes would be doing for us. There we go. 15 minutes definitely gave us a push once again. Confident push to the upside on 15 minutes. As you can see, it was climbing quite nicely right there. We took our buys right here on our 11.0.69, pushed up. Now we don't have a current at the moment. We don't have an entry point on 15 minutes. 5 minutes probably will be giving us a low at the moment. 1 minute will be pushing up but down, so we should expect an entry point, a buy entry very soon before we can actually start being more confident on our sellers should the market actually resist and not go higher any longer. Not forgetting the bigger picture, I'm gonna go back to the big time frame over 2 hours, so we do not actually forget what exactly we are trying to see. Here's our bigger picture. I did highlight a downtrend, so I will bring it back up again and show you guys obviously how exactly to highlight your trade. Just like that. So as you can see, that high obviously was respected. The market kept bouncing off that top and kept on pushing down. Right now, I do have my red resistant support section right there. If that support gets broken, obviously we're going up to the upside. Support gets resisted, we're pushing down one more time. I say double bottom. Obviously, that does not necessarily mean the market will no longer come down. If the market does refuse to go higher than this right now, we definitely are seeing our sellers coming quite heavy. That's our slight breakdown on that.